Ruby is a great language just on its own in a various scenarios. So as of now, we have seen Groovy introduction, how it is lightweight and how many ways, how many APIs Groovy can be fit into. So before going to see other examples, first we will see a basic example with the Java. So as of now in Java, we have many approaches. First we'll try to see three approaches and then we'll see the best approach which we can write a Groovy script for Java. And alternatively, along with this, below four approaches also, we have a Bean scripting framework also, which can scripting language fit into the Java code. So we'll see one by one example. First one is evaluate scripts or expressions using cell. So this is my script test.groovy script file. So we know like groovy file name should be like extends with .groovy. So file name is test. So how we have a Java file .java, like with Groovy also .groovy. So here I created a method. So instead of system.out.println, right, like in Java, in Groovy, we'll have a println. And as we discussed earlier, Groovy is something like similar to Java. And how we have a methods, classes, we can create in Groovy also. Something like Groovy, without creating classes also, we can write a number of lines and number of methods, and we can write a code in classes also. So as of now, I have created a method that is called hello underscore world. Inside that, I am displaying hello world message. So first example, so we are trying to executing this script by the shell. How shell will execute, we'll see. You can evaluate any expression or a script in Groovy using Groovy shell, and Groovy shell allow you to pass in and out out variables via binding object. So we'll try to invoke the method, and which method we are trying to call and what parameters we need to pass it to Groovy. So that can be done by a Groovy shell. It's something like invoking that method. And that is the first approach. And the second approach is something like evaluate scripts with a common base class. So this is something like we'll create a script file which is extends script, and we'll try to write a Groovy script which this class can be called by the compiler configuration, which we have a method called set script base class. So this is something like it is often useful to make your Groovy script extends a base class of your choosing, so that the script can access common methods. So obviously, whenever we write a class in script, it should be common. Otherwise, it's a waste of use to have that class inside a script. And this can be achieved by setting the script base class. So how we are setting the script class name? By the set script base class. So this is a second approach. And third approach is dynamically loading. So we are trying to load a class based on the Groovy class loader. So we can use the Groovy class loader to load classes dynamically into a Java program. So whatever Groovy have it, right, we'll try to load by the Groovy class loader. And once it is loaded to the Java program, we'll try to execute them directly. So we are loading that Groovy script into a Java and executing them directly. So the following code can be seen. See, for example, like a Groovy class loader, and we are passing the class by test.groovy, and we are creating instance of that class. So something like we are creating something how we have class loading, right? We are doing like that. So something like how we load driver classes for database, something like that. We are loading that Groovy script as a Java. then we are trying to executing it. So other than these above three approaches, we have one more approach also, that is something like a Groovy Script Engine. So the most complete solution for people who wanted to embed Groovy Scripts into their servers and having them reloaded on modification is the Groovy Script Engine. If you see right above approaches, for example dynamically loading, this approach if you see right, we are trying to make it as a Java and trying to call the method, so something like heavy approach. And second one is something like you are creating, and this is also again loading as a script, so creating a class and making it use, and this is your invocation. So comparing with all these approaches, heavy approaches, script engine is the best one. So this is something like loading script by name, I mean whichever you want to load it will have a option, and we have a we can initiate the Groovy script engine with a set of class path like a roots, that can be URLs or any direct names. You can then execute any Groovy script within those roots. So something like if you have a option, it is not something like you should not load everything based on what can be loaded and what can be executed. And GSE, something like Groovy Script Engine, will also track dependencies between scripts, so that if any dependent script is modified, the whole tree will be recompiled and reloaded. So this is something like Groovy Script Engine is lightweight comparing with above three approaches. Additionally, each time you can run a script, you can pass in a binding that contains properties that the script can access it. Any properties set in the script will also be available in that binding after script has run. So if you see right, this is the below example. So nothing much you need to worry, just you have to add these lines of code and which method you wanted to load it. So running Groovy also, it's not a big deal. So we'll try to write a small example out of these four approaches. So I have already written a program which I have executed practically. So this is the class loader. I have written a class with three methods, and this is for a Groovy script engine, using Groovy script engine. This is running with a common base class and calling that script file. So this is the and for this, as we discussed, we need a script file where placed in SRC main resources, and to execute this file we need a dependency which is required for Groovy, that is called Groovy all. So I have used 2.3.1. so this is already public static void main, so inside that only I am trying to call these three methods, so no need to worry about anything. So to compare this, we have a dependency, so as it is copy paste and try to run how this script can be executed. So as we discussed earlier, I am trying to call the method which I have which is available inside a test Groovy file. So if you execute it right, you will get three times hello world, because I am trying to call this test.groovy file in three different ways. One is Groovy class loader, other one is Groovy script engine, other one is using common base class. Thank you.